Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to be discussing logarithms. One good thing about this topic is that every single person on earth utilizes logarithms on a daily basis. I'm sure you are wondering, what's this guy talking about? Yes. You know what 10 is. I'm sure you also know what 100 is. 1,000. 10,000. You deal with these numbers on a daily basis. You know that 100 is 10 times 10. The same way you know that 10 is 10 times 1. So I'm just going to write that as 10. You know that 1,000 is 10 times 10 times 10. And also 10,000 is 10 times 10 times 10 times 10. So, because we've got a single 10 here, I'm going to write this as 10 to the power of 1. Of course, you know this. 100 has 10 to the power of 2. 1,000 has 10 to the power of 3. 10,000 has 10 to the power of 4. I can keep going. Why is 10 10 to the power of 1? Why is 100 10 to the power of 2? 1,000, 10 to the power of 3, 10,000, 10 to the power of 4. You know all of this, but why is that so? This is where logarithm comes in. 10 is 10 to the power of 1 because the logarithm of 10 base 10 is equal to 1. 100 is 10 to the power of 2 because the logarithm of 100 base 10 is 2. 1,000 is 10 to the power of 3 because the logarithm of 1,000 base 10 is 3. And finally, 10,000 is 10 to the power of 4 because log 10,000 base 10 is equal to 4. None of this is restricted to 10. I can also extend it to any number. For example, let's pick 5. We know that 5 to the power of 1 is 5. 5 to the power of 2 is 25. 5 to the power of 3 is 125. Now, 5 to the power of 1 is 5 because the logarithm of 5 to base 5 gives 1. Similarly, 5 squared is 25 because the logarithm of 25 to base 5 is 2, and 5 to the power of 3 is 125 because the logarithm of 125 to base 5 is equal to 3. So this is the beauty about mathematics. The ability to allow us generalize. Now, looking at this pattern, so we can define logarithms as, here is it, the logarithm of a number in a given base is the power at which the base is raised. So we can verify that here. So to generalize this, what it means is that the log of a number, so we're going to call the number b. So a certain base, let's take a base of a. So if the logarithm is x, what it implies is that a to the power of x is going to be equal to b. This is exactly what the statement is talking about. The logarithm of a number to a given base, so here, a here is the base, x is the value of the logarithm, while b is the number whose logarithm is sought. So what we see in these examples on the left is just an indication of what is written in yellow. So if log b to base a is equal to x, the implication is that a raised to the power of x is going to be equal to b. This is basically the relationship between indices and logarithm. So here is indices because we've got an index, and this is the logarithmic version. Now we've got several representations of logarithms. The most common one is called the common log. So a common log is the logarithm to the base of 10. So whenever the logarithm of a number is written to the base of 10, this is called a common log. So by default on your calculator, what you have is common log, and the short form of writing log to base 10 is just LG. So if it's not written as log to base 10, it's just going to be written as LG. So we can apply the definition of logarithms to solve problems. For example, to solve log 27 base 3, the first thing we are going to have to do here is to represent this with a letter, because this is going to have a numerical value. So let's represent that with a letter. So let's log 27 base 3 be x. Now, having done this, we can just apply this definition that relates the logarithmic version to the indices version. So since log b to base a equal to x is always going to produce a to the power of x equals b. So comparing this log b to base a with log 27 base 3, we would see that a is 3 and b is 27. So this is going to produce 3 to the power of x equal to 27. So we know that from basic indices, if a to the power of x equals a to the power of y, what it implies is that x is going to be equal to y. So basically, what this tells us is that if the bases are the same, the indices would also be the same. So what we can do here is to write 27 as a number to the power of 3. So that's very straightforward, because we know that 27 is 3 times 3 times 3, and this is 3 cubed. So what we have here, 3 to the power of x is going to be equal to 3 to the power of 3. Since the bases are the same, so we are just going to equate the indices. So we are going to have x equal to 3. So finally, what it implies is that the log of 27 base 3 is equal to 3. And this makes sense from the definition, because 3 to the power of 3 is 27. In the next video, I'm going to be treating the theory of logarithms. Such a theory would allow me to solve a problem like this. Log 0.0001 base 10. So see you in the next video. Thank you.